Hello and welcome to NewsClick. Today we are joined by Surjukanta Mishra, the State Secretary of the CPIM in West Bengal and also the Politburo member of the Communist Party of India Marxist. Thank you so much for joining us, and we're going to be talking about the situation in Bengal, the efforts being made by the left to work for the issues of the people, as well as the situation regarding communalism there. So to begin with, could you first talk a bit about right now what's happening regarding the COVID-19 situation, one, and also after Cyclone Amphan came and caused more devastation. So there's been a lot of criticism of the government's response as well. So could you talk a bit about how the government's response has been and what are the failures identified by the left?
No, we were in the COVID pandemic before Amphan came. So the people, you know, that all over the country, the job losses and the migrant workers stranded in other states, and no time, the government didn't have any plan, and all that, the sufferings they had to go through. And on the first day one, this became the one of the urgent problem that we had to address, to see how to connect them, how to reach them wherever they are, in whichever state. Contacting our party, trade union had taken independent initiative, students, youth and women, these other people, mass organizations, they had taken their initiative. So that was the challenge. But the government simply didn't do anything. And besides that, we had to take care of the people here in our state itself. Right from tea garden to jute industry to all these industries closed and these shops, establishments, all these unorganized workforce in particular. And they had no salary. Naturally, this particularly the unorganized sector, they had, it's a hand-to-mouth situation, and that even that without the salary, it become difficult. And the government response was very poor. I mean, the union government or the state government. And they were not prepared also. So it is that time that in such a situation, we had been trying to reach them, organizing people in the locality. It was a decentralized initiative. It's not much central thing, but it's a very good response from the people. The local people, they organized the community kitchens, and there is the people first with the awareness program, providing them soap, sanitizers, and we leaflet about what is to be done and what not to be done. And also then the food. And we had helpline organized by some organizations like People's Select Committee here and this Students' Health Home, they organized helpline so that people can contact, particularly for non-COVID cases, that become a problem. The other thing it is in such a difficult situation that it become complicated with this Amphan, and is a devastating effect on at least 8 districts. Particularly the coastal districts here. And there's a situation when you can't talk about physical distancing and all that. Right. People don't have home and all that. They have to leave for shelters and water, food, all this became a problem. And there also the government could not reach them. And because of Amphan, there have been interruption of electricity, no network, connectivity. All this became a very difficult situation, and ultimately depended upon the local initiative of the people, which is, that's a great thing that the people did, they come out, and we could reach almost everywhere. And after this Amphan, the stage is over, but rehabilitation of the people, providing them shelter and reconstruction, ultimately house and all that. And the demand that we made for declaring this as a national calamity was not accepted by the government of India. They provided some 1,000 crores. And the state government here also, this the water taken, there are lack of transparency, this way they did it, and the people who have three-story building got the housing, the help for reconstruction of their houses, where the homeless people didn't get anything. So also it happened to the rations, the MR shops, their supply. So the all the front we had to work, even electricity has to be restored because of the lot of trees that obstruction that we created, and we had to remove them. That's there also, government was late. So, but now the situation as it stands, that what we say forewarned a month back, that the pandemic is in a stage of community transmission that has started.
Right.
Government defied them. Now, of course, the state government yesterday, or day before yesterday, they have started saying there are evidences of community transmission. So this is what we said. And we said that we have a lot more to see, because the challenge ahead is much more worse than what you see today. Maybe the peak could be somewhere in September, so the full month of August before us. And it has become so difficult because of the lack of testing. That is
right.
Our key words to face this pandemic, that is testing and testing, then tracking, then isolation, then quarantine treatment, all these things were not taken care of. So now the situation has gone beyond the control, I should say, the union government or the state government. And the two states that had, number of testing is the lowest among the states, Gujarat and West Bengal. So, and that becomes a problem. One ruled by BJP, the Prime Minister's state, and then by PMC. Yeah. So, and we also said that it's not only the antigen testing, RT-PCR, but we should go for rapid for antibody testing to monitor the course the pandemic takes and how it is spreading and all that. So that they didn't do. In fact, we in ourselves, we had to start with my state committee members, them for antibody too. But some district committee members in the district committee meeting were came to attend physically when it could be possible. But the government has not taken it up. So the basic things that to manage this pandemic, they were neglected. And the livelihood issues not have now come into the forefront. The question is that how long the people who are starving are going to abide by the physical distancing and all that? When the choice is between COVID-19, corona, and starvation, as you know, that people say that we must live first, then we can fight corona. That's I can die without food. So that thing, and it is under such a situation, a difficult situation, I should say. But whatever could be done, it is because thanks to the people, and their effort, the help that they extended, and the mass organizations and the other volunteer organizations and all that, they also had some initiative.
Right.
But this flood has started in North Bengal also. That is another problem, adjoining Assam and all that. So it's a multidimensional problem, and the attack is also multidimensional. I mean, the government policies, union government policies, this response of the state, that, and as you said, the type of polarization that is taking place in the country, and how this pandemic and the Disaster Management Act, all these were utilized to intensify the attack on the livelihood of the people, life and livelihood of the people. Number two, on the democratic rights and the right to protest, and then of course utilize the pandemic to further polarize, to intensify the polarization based on the religion and all that, right? Communal polarization for the purpose that they want. So that's why it becomes a multi-pronged challenge that we have to face.
Absolutely.
And I believe that it's now that with the help of the People Initiative and all that, we are in a situation when some degree of confidence there has been a situation when people can move past the situation with more confidence, but we keep on telling them, and we believe that's very important, that not to be panic in this situation, mm-hmm. not to be careless also. This awareness campaign has been intensified, and we have been trying our best to see whatever government is not able to give, that's, as I said, the food the awareness campaign, or this blood, when it comes to the question of blood donation also, it's all people who donated blood. When it came to the helpline, it's made be for the migrant worker or made be for somebody suffering from a non-COVID ailment. The helpline is, we had to do it, we had to arrange it for these things. Even somewhere, education, primary.
Right.
So all this case, we are trying to give an alternative, whatever is possible. It's not simply criticizing the government, but to see that whatever you can do, that mass initiative can be unleashed.
So in this context, I also wanted to ask, because there have been a lot of reports in recent times about how the parties, cadres, are going to places where until recently, due to violence, they were not able to have much of a presence. Offices are being reopened. So could you talk a bit also about the kind of response that has come from the people to the relief work organized by the CPIM and its mass friends, and how the CPIM itself is seeing this relief work?
No, you see, as I said, we had a two-pronged initiative. One is to unleash the initiative of the people to see that looking for something that the government provides without waiting for that. And at the same time, fighting against the anti-people policy of the government. So for management of COVID is concerned, the response after Amphan, or even the flood now, all that situation, and and the corruption, the massive scale corruption, that means, as I said, that the house building grants were given to people who had three-story, four-story building, have car and air condition in their rooms, and they either belong to BJP or, TMC, these people in panchayat, and the municipalities, corporations, and all that. So, the movement against that, the movement for the food, movement for the ration, movement for that 7,500 rupees reach these families. And also the movement against the union government policy now to sell away the public sector units to the corporates, whether national or foreign, and disinvestment in all the state sector, all sectors. So, and the attack on the workers, the working hours and all this. So we had to unleash movement, actually organize movements. We had a very successful strike in the coal sector, coal mine. 95% people responded to in the strike, three days continuous strike in this period.
Right.
And also, and other industries. So, besides the movement of the students, you see, against the type of attacks they are facing, particularly now this the proposal of this having this online exam and all that. The youth, particularly, that were in the forefront in all these struggles, whether providing relief or the quarantine camps for those who returned, were not looked after by the government. They simply said that we have spent so much, but we have to arrange it. It's their accommodation, their fooding, and all that, and to look after them. And at the same time, the movement, as you see, that helped us to reach areas and the peoples where we were not able to reach because of the terror that has been unleashed, I mean, since 2011, right now, also. But this is first time that we could break through in many areas. And as the people, there's a sort of upsurge in people in some areas. And I would not say that... it is that everywhere it could be possible, but in many areas that we could reach people, and the offices which were closed since 2011 for 9 years or over 9 years now are now being opened, and newer people coming to us, even people who for some reason or other had been with the TMC or gone to TMC or BJP. There's hundreds of them come back every day and join our movements. That's a development, I think.
Very well. Absolutely.
But I think we have a lot more things to do and long way to go.
Right. So in this context, we are still, of course, dealing with the issues of the pandemic, but at the same time, there is talk about the elections that are coming up next year. And a key component in this is the role of the BJP. And now we have seen over the years, especially in the last 2 to 3 years, there's been a massive amount of polarization on the ground, a very concerted attempt to create divisions in society. So could you talk a bit about what is happening on those lines and how the left is fighting back?
Polarization is nothing new now. You know, it's whatever happening in the country. But the Bengal situation is a bit different. It is because... it is this TMC, the Trinamool Congress, which brought BJP into the state. I mean, it is during this government time, the RSS could, increased its number of the sakhas, branches or whatever. I mean, it is almost trebled or quadrupled in some areas, particularly North Bengal in particular. And because it is this... whatever our chief minister or TMC chief speaks against BJP would not utter a word about RSS. That is the thing they have been allowed to grow. And now because of the composition of the population of our state, the partisan, they are joining borders and all that make it more sensitive area. And it's also a fertile ground for the communal forces to further communalize and, polarize the communal polarization, intensify the communal polarization. So it has been a challenging task. And particularly when this government, the state government, takes such a stand where it appears to fight BJP, but on the long run, so far policies are concerned, they are no different, the same policies. So, but the corruption scandals are concerned, they are no different. And the attack on democracy, it is here that it started first and had helped BJP to grow. The attack on the left and trying to marginalize the left, the main force that will ideologically fight the right, political right, the communal forces. And so it has been the dual role that the ruling party here is playing and trying to confuse people. Now, Fortunately, because of these developments now, and after all that the migrant workers had to go through, and when they're coming back home, they have learned from their experience the character of the state and the union government. And that helps us to fight this polarization in a better way than it was possible before. So far as the party is concerned, the direction, the movement, one is of independent activity of the party. Second, we have Left Front. This is historically, it was formed in 1970s, the latter half, and so to consolidate the unity among the left. And since there are left parties outside the Left Front, we have formed a broader combination of the Left Front, left outside the Left Front, and others, secular parties, and those who had been with the left, So there are now 16 parties or so, and sometimes 17 parties in certain program. We can, jointly move so far the movements are concerned. And so, independent initiative, Left Front, Left Plus, and then all the anti-TMC and anti-BJP forces, secular forces, anti-TMC, including the Congress, but it's not only Congress. All anti-TMC, anti-BJP forces. It's forces means forces. It's not parties only. It's parties, forces, individuals, groups, and all that. They're all welcome. And so there are issues, broad issues, when particularly that the campaign against the NRC and the CAA and all that, like that, the issue of Kashmir and so many other issues like that, where we could have combined initiative together and given it a formidable step. So that effort continues, and that's the united struggle. We have been trying to broadest platform of united struggle. The Left Front has to have be there. It's a front. Means it has some political alliance having an understanding about the agenda, the agenda of the left, or even left outside the Left Front. And but besides that, we are trying to reach the other secular democratic forces that we can mobilize. So that platform of struggle, that is very important. It's elections and all that, yes, it will come next year only, but that is not the pressing thing now. But what is important is the struggle of the people, the unity of the people against this polarization, against the BJP, and the particularly the communal polarization that is getting intensified. And as I said, the situation has been utilized by the ruling class and the ruling party in the center and the state to further polarize it. And that's why broadest possible unity of the people has become a matter of serious concern that we had been trying to forge.
Thank you so much, sir, for talking to us.
Okay, thank you very much. I think that we'll have other occasions when situation develops further.
Absolutely. That's all we have time for today. Keep watching Newsweek.